I started talking a little bit about the UN exam and how I trained for that, and I told you that I would give you more of an example of how I did that. And so I'd like to tell you a little bit about how I did that. So I'm just going to pull up one page, and the page that I'm going to pull up is the UN Digital Recordings Portal. Now, this is not the same thing as the UN Web TV page, which is what a lot of people are familiar with when they go looking for UN recordings. The UN webcast, or the Web TV, is audio and video. The thing about that, though, is that you usually only get just the original, the floor language, and often the English. So those of us in the English booth will be memorialized for all eternity on that page. But you don't get the other channels there. The good news is that the UN has a very little known portal where they've got tons and tons and tons and tons of recordings in all of the languages of a meeting. So this is what it looks like, as you can see, the UN Digital Recordings Portal. The link will be in the slides, so you'll be able to follow that and practice with it if you'd like to practice the way that I did. So here it is, it's the Digital Recordings Portal, and you can go in and you can select the date. So you can see that this month there haven't been any meetings, but if we go for a custom range, say, go back to January, and we'll just, I don't know, look for the month of January, you can see that it pulls up all of the different meetings that took place there at the UN, public, private, etc. So a lot of the meetings are behind closed doors. Those are only accessible to people with the password, but there are a lot of meetings that are public, and those are great for studying. Here's why. So just a little aside here, the UN on the 16th of January had a full day where they were talking about very geeky things about technology and interpreting. And you can actually go back and listen to these speeches from this InnoVent event, Digital Tools for Conference Interpreting. That's an interesting one there. So we'll just go there and I'll show you what it looks like. You can see that you've got all of the speakers labeled. You can hit play to listen to them, or you can download that language. Now, right here, it says select audio language floor. That's because this was a monolingual event. But let's go in and find another event that was not monolingual, the Committee on the Rights of the Child, 83rd session, which took place in Palais Wilson on the ground floor. You can see here that I've got four options, floor, English, French, and Spanish, which are the working languages of that meeting. If the meeting had all six UN languages, you'd have all six of them. Sometimes there's an extra language too, and you'll have that here. And then you can actually go in, and for any given speech, you pick the language that you want to be listening to for that speech. Let's not start the chair speaking in French here. And you can also have the floor as well. You can download the current language you're listening to, or download all languages. Now, it's not the easiest interface in the world. So I see a good question from Christina. Can you search by language with filtering? Unfortunately, I don't believe you can. What you can do is search by meeting, organization right here. And if you know the languages that are used as working languages for a given meeting, then you can go to that meeting and you're likely to find the ones that are only in those languages. It requires a little bit of knowledge of the UN, but certain treaty bodies, for example, tend to have certain languages, and that's how you can find that. So, okay, I've downloaded all of my recordings, right? I went in, I found the originals that I wanted, and I find, that's what I'm going to practice from, right, the floor, and I'm also downloading the rendition into my target language, in this case, English. So let me just take you back to Audacity. Okay, so we've got the same speech from before. The original, you can see it's labeled original right here. That's was French in this case, right? So I had to go in and do a little bit of scouting, but I found a nice 15-minute original speech in French. For those of you working from English and wanting to practice from English, you'll find plenty of options there. But it took me a little bit of hunting to find the one that I wanted in French. I downloaded it plus the other rendition. And then I can simply, in Audacity, in addition to recording my own speech, I can import audio. So I go to File, Import, Audio. Let's make sure I find this one, 906. I've given it a little star to make it easy for me to find. Let's see if it works properly. All righty. So here it is, the English version. So what does that mean? That means that's the rendition done by the staff interpreter or freelance interpreter who was working at that meeting that day. So there are some really cool things that you can do with this for training purposes. On the one hand, so here you can see the English has popped up down here. That's the English channel. This was my rendition in the middle, just a short one, not the real thing, but it was a demo. So I can now mute mine. I could mute the original and only listen back to the staff interpreter, right? Let's take a listen.
Merci bien, monsieur le.
Thank you very much, Chairman.
There you have it. Or I could choose to listen to two tracks at once. And this is what I did most of the time to train for the UN exam. So what I did is I used panning. And you see right here, there are some controls for more volume, less volume. And I can adjust that. But under that, I have left and right pan. And so I would put myself in one ear and the staff interpreter. Just saying staff interpreter, the person who was working that day, it may not have been a staff interpreter.
You mean the correct interpretation.
I pick the ones that I want to listen to, and let's take a listen.
It's an honor for me to take the floor. Before this august
and address this august meeting. Assembly. Right, so there's some interesting variation there. It can be a good way to listen and compare. This is what I did, basically to learn the terminology used at the UN. I listened to hours of recordings after I'd done it myself. Hey, it's dedication, but I mean, a lot of people ask how you do it. It's not an easy exam to pass, but this is what I did. And of course, you can also choose to, for example, put the original on the right ear, mute the staff interpreter, and just listen to myself in the original.
En matière de gestion de la dette publique.
And so I'm not going to go into detail. It's just an example, right? We're not going to listen to Josh's demo rendition here, but this is how you do it if you want to have multi-channel recording and compare yourself.